Keely. And good morning, my Aussies and Kiwis. How are you? It is good to see you again. And I have missed you. It's been a couple of years because I wasn't able to make this event last year. So for some of you, I haven't seen you for 2 years. And I have missed you, but I still follow you. I follow your business very closely. I chat to Rachel often. I get to catch up with our diamonds and leaders all around the world as we travel. We've had a great day yesterday, haven't we? The content was good. I get a feeling we're kind of, you know, getting back to basics. I don't know if you noticed a theme almost, but there were some similarities between what Paula said and what Kathy said and even what Schultze said in his presentation. Do you think that, is that by coincidence? Not really, because when we talk about this business, there are simple ways to do it and there's complex ways to do it. The simple way to do it is what works and is what all of the great network marketing leaders talk about. It is what you see those in the front row, the diamonds, doing. And that's what I'd like to dissect a little bit more today. So you may even hear repetition from me. I want to talk about two topics today. And it's, to me, they are the most important two topics in this industry. And I'm going to play a horrible game. It's guess the teacher's mind. What do you think are the two things that I'm going to talk about on stage today? What are the two most fundamental principles of MLM direct selling? What do you think? Give me some key words. What's that?
Prospecting.
Prospecting, okay, prospecting. I've got a different word for it, recruiting, but yes, that's one of them. What's the other one? What else do you think? Patience? A duplication. Okay, bingo, recruitment and duplication. I'm proud of you. You guessed my mind, you guessed the two key words. And it really does come down, and you think, oh, you know, we've heard this before. No, you will hear it again, and you'll hear it again and again and again, because when you've been doing this business for 20, 30 years, most of what you present is recruitment and duplication. That's what we need to know, that's what we need to understand, because when you go to the leaders and say, what is the key to your success, it really boils down to understanding and mastering these two basic principles. If you don't get it, you're not going to have success. Now, I want you to look at me. I want you to look at me over my 20-year career. This is what I haven't changed. I think most of these are recent photos probably, but what I have done for 20 years, I've stood on stage and I've talked about direct selling principles. In all honesty, I have never been a distributor. You know that? I tell people, and people always ask, Chris, why haven't you been a distributor? Or have you thought about becoming a distributor? And of course I've thought about it, because for my whole career, I've specialized in helping people make a whole lot more money than what I have ever earned in my career. I have watched people and helped people earn millions of dollars, whereas I don't earn that. So do I think about, can I do what you do? And I often wonder, I have great respect. What you do is very difficult. It is hard. It can be hard. There's full of setbacks. And I think about my own nature and what I do. And I know, I feel I have what it could be described as a character flaw. It's hard for me to admit that. But I feel that I'm not very good at duplication. If you know my management style, I get really involved. And I like to do almost everything. I guess the megalomaniac, big power hungry. Now I'm talking to my boss here now, who is just still getting to know me. But I have this tendency to think that I can do the things best or better than other people. Often when something hits the table, I think I can either delegate it, and it's going to take me half an hour to tell someone how to do it the way I want it done, or I can just do it myself. Do you know what I do? I just do it myself. Kathy's nodding, right? I think we're sisters in this, right? You're the same. My niece posted this on my sister-in-law's Facebook the other day. And when I saw it, I laughed. I went, oh, this is so my sister-in-law. I went, oh, hold on. This is me too. It says, when your mom is being dramatic as, and I had to bleep this word out, dramatic as and having one of her, I'm the only person who does anything in this bloody house, you'll miss me when I'm dead moments. Resonate with anyone? Is this anyone? Yeah, you okay. So we're kindred spirits. This is me, and I tend to do that. I remember when I was at university, I lived with six guys in this big house, And I would come home at the end of the day, so I have to do lots of homework. But the first thing I'd do is I'd go to the sink, and almost like in a frenzy, I'd be like slamming the dishes in the dishwasher, saying pretty much, I'm the only person in the bloody house who does anything. You'll miss me when I'm dead. And they'd look at me and kind of laugh, and it became my routine. And I kind of realized that my breaking point for the dishes was sooner than theirs. That if I didn't do that, they'd eventually do it. But for some reason, I don't know why, I had to do it. I had to come home, and that was kind of my interval, my gap to defrag my mind. And I'd do this dishes thing every day, and I'd get the dishes done, because then I could get back into it and do homework. And I'm still like that at home. If I'm working from home, I have to make sure the laundry's done, the dishes are clean, all of those other jobs are done, then I can focus. Okay, there's a lot of us who may wear this shirt, and particularly mums, it's the I'll just do it myself, every mum ever. Anyone? Anyone hypothetically, metaphorically wearing this shirt in their life? Okay, so my problem is I am this type of person, and that is contrary to duplication. That is not good, that does not help with duplication. I'm going to talk about recruitment today for a little bit, but I want to spend most of my time talking about duplication, because if I can achieve anything in my 30 minutes on stage, I want you to understand the importance of duplication and how. So the theme is back to basics. We're getting back to basics with this. And the most fundamental, the most basic is recruitment and duplication. I wanted, Roy and I talk a lot strategically about the markets. We're very paternal like parents and analyzing stats and data. And there is something that does concern me here in Aussie and New Zealand. The reason why we need to understand these principles is because right now we're not doing so well at it. Our sales are good. Our sales have kind of have held strong the last couple of years, or consistent. But something is changing, and it's something that you need to be aware of. Our recruitment numbers are dropping. When we looked at 2017 to 2018, this is total numbers. So we over 20,000 people joined Jeunesse in 2017. But in 2018, that dropped quite a bit to 7,000 maybe. When I look at month by month, on a monthly average in 2017, over 1,800 a month, but 2018 dropped down quite a bit, 2019. New Zealand, you're doing okay, but you know, a bit better, but still dropping down a bit. You're doing, what was it, 1,000 down to a bit less than 800. Month by month, you're doing 80 a month, down a bit, and this is January, how we've started in January. Okay, crisis, not at all. Not a great concern, because your sales are still good. But if this trend does not change, then it becomes concerning. This is what I refer to this as. Do this, put your fingers on the pulse right now. This is the pulse of your business. When you go to the doctor, no matter what you're dealing with, this is the first thing that he does. When you want to say, how is my business, feel your recruitment. Honestly, how is your recruitment beating in your blood, in your heart? What's the pulse of your business? If you are not recruiting, you will have longer term challenges in your business. You need to be recruiting always. And I think someone else said that yesterday in their presentation, the vitality of continual recruitment. When you look at our top leaders, when you look at them in the front row, you know, Lyndon we know the best because we observe what he does. Lyndon stands on stage, he travels a whole lot, but you know what he's always doing, always in his spare time, he's on the phone. When he's traveling, he may be on stage, but always supplemental to that, he is always recruiting. I have never seen him stop recruiting, despite the diamond, then to double diamond. Why we need to do this, and this may be a new word for some of us, there's this thing called attrition. That no matter how good you are, no matter how great a leader you are, there will always be attrition. Attrition is like a natural decay, a natural falling away. Our tendency when we begin this business is we launch with so much excitement, and when you first begin, you focus 100% of your attention on recruitment. It's all about getting that massive groundswell, getting those people to join your business. Then when you've finally got a good chunk of leadership and you've started duplicating a bit, you've got other leaders, you then tend to focus away from recruitment. And you may focus for a season on retention, which is fine. They're all noble things. But if you turn your head away from recruitment, if you ignore that, the attrition. So some people will jump. It's like the hole in the bucket. There'll always be a little seepage, a little bit of loss, but you always need to keep filling that. If you stop for too long, one day you turn around and say, what happened to my business? I have been such a fantastic presenter, traveling the world. My ego is on such a high, but I ignored recruiting, and it's now caught up with me to my detriment. So, enrolling. Let's talk a little bit about rolling. You like my groovy animation? Let me show you that again. Watch this. My enrolling steps. You launch your own business with a major blast. This is how it begins. So when you begin, brand new person, a major blast. You use tools, third-party tools and leaders. You have home meetings, one-on-one invitations. These are just fundamental recruitment tools that work. Discover Jeunesse, opportunity meetings. You bring along your prospects to these meetings. We've got online presentations. Are we still doing them? Right from my beginning, like 6 years ago, every week, Australia and then Africa, two webinars a week, so we're still doing them, Aussie? Good. That's such a good duplication, online presentations, week after week. There's always been the call, like, why don't you just do one really good and record it and play it week after? No, for some reason, we've said live. We're going to do live presentations every week. Also, retail customers, not number one, but it's still a good source of our prospects enrolling your business. So what you do when for enrolling, you launch your own business. These are your main tools for enrolling that you utilize. Then, once you start getting a critical mass, you then launch your recruits' businesses with major blasts. So then a lot of your time is spent helping your recruits do their own. Boom, boom, blasting, duplication, repetition. I almost steal these next words out of this Kathy's mouth. It's slightly different. The person who makes the most presentations wins. What'd you say with the person with the pen? Paula. The person who holds the marker makes the money. Okay, the person who makes the most presentations win. Same, same, but different, but same. When you're making presentations, you are the winner. You can do better. You can always refine your presentation. But what matters most is you just got to be presenting. And not this type of fancy presenting, one-on-one, three-way calls, home meetings, whatever the presentation. As long as you're opening your mouth and speaking about Jeunesse, you are a winner, and you're becoming more and more of a winner. You are making money. That's what makes the money, is presenting. So I looked at Aussie and New Zealand, how are we doing? And there's a little sneaky thing that I look at occasionally. This is my finger on the pulse for Aussie New Zealand, and it's our back office, our Jeunesse Australasia events section. And I have to say, you're doing pretty good, guys. You're still at it. You're still grinding away with the meetings. When I look, March the 6th, I finished West Ryde. March the 11th, Brisbane. East Melbourne, Sydney, Wellington, Perth, Christchurch, Wellington, Auckland. Hey, Kiwis, you're like almost 50% of the live meetings happening right now. Good on you, Kiwis. Doing good in New Zealand. So at least, what's this? Like every maybe 3 to 4 days on average, we're still doing a meeting. This is good. This is the pen. This is the presenting. This is what makes the money. Also look at the different venues, because I'm going to talk about that soon as well. Okay, again, why I talk about this, I want to move on to duplication. But you need to understand the importance of enrollment. Just like I said, that the finger on the pulse, this is, so why I'm choosing to address this today, I call it the canary in the coal mine. You know this analogy, right? When miners used to go down, they'd actually bring canaries, happy little chirping canaries. The reason why is they are more sensitive to the gases under the ground, to the carbon monoxide, other gases, that they will get sick and die first before humans. So you bring the canary and you look at the canary. How's the canary's health? Even though I'm doing fine, whoop, my canary just got sick. That's your early warning system, your early warning signal. So I'm telling you, Aussies, Kiwis, you got to get back to recruitment, because we've slowed down. Our sales are still good. Our sales are strong. But here today, we know our numbers are a bit fewer than last year, fewer than the year before. We've been distracted. I think we've built our business. We've launched. Maybe we've become a bit complacent, or we've focused our direction elsewhere. you know, I'm doing lots of travel, lots of training. But no matter who you are or how big you are, biggest people in the front row, they are still recruiting and probably still recruiting harder than people in the back rows. So remember that. Now, duplication. I watched this horror movie the other day, a scary movie, and it had a most brilliant scene. And I thought, I need to grab this and I need to show this on stage because this impresses upon you the power of duplication under duress. Let's have a look.
I'm going to give you a math riddle, okay? And you're going to tell me the answer.
What?
How much would you have if I said I would pay you a penny on the first day, and then 2 pennies on the second, and then 4 pennies on the third day, and I just kept doubling, and I did this for a month? How much money would you have at the end of the month?
$10.
Oh, hi. Just keep looking at me. Just keep looking at me.
$20.
No, keep going. Keep going.
It's $30.
I'm going to tell you the answer. It's over $10 million. You'd have over $10 million at the end of the month.
Okay, bit scary, but the message, the power of duplication, impressing upon her under great duress, the power of duplication, how it works, the impact. If this was a finance meeting, I'd say this is the power of compounding interest. If you know it, you'll earn it. If you don't, you pay it, right? Now I'm talking to Kathy again. She's like lit up. We're talking finance, investments. Lyndon, can I ask you, sorry, I probably should have pre-warned you, but in your business, your Jeunesse, 7 years, 8 years? 8 years? 7 years. Do you mind revealing how many people you've personally sponsored in your 8 years in Jeunesse? Okay, 150 people in 8 years. But can you tell me, do you know how many people in your whole business, your downline now? 400,000. How is that possible if Lyndon has not spoken to 400,000 people, if he's only personally signed up 150 people, whatever? It's duplication. Now, I want to talk about duplication, but I want to take it one level higher because this, I feel, if you can understand this, you will crack the code to success in MLM. I call it facilitating duplication. The MLM secret of success and wealth is facilitating duplication in your team, which is slightly different. Now, let me explain it to you this way. I have a bucket list, one thing I really want to do in my life. I saw this as a child, and I want to see this. In China, they have taught cormorants how to fish. Have you seen this before on YouTube or TV? So they get cormorant birds, and they either put a metal ring around their neck or some string. They tie the string, and these birds go off, and they're flying, diving in, picking up the fish, and bringing the fish back to the master. But they can't swallow, right, because they've got string. So many Chinese in the room. Has anyone seen this live? Where do they do it? Peter Gu, you've seen live cormorant fishing? I'd love to see it. So they've trained the birds to be the fishermen, and they bring the fish back, and then eventually they loosen the string, and then they get to eat some of the fish. So there's a famous analogy. I know you've heard it. They say that's a Chinese proverb. They say, give a man a fish, and you feed him for a day. Teach a man to fish, and you feed him for a lifetime. I like it. I like it a lot. But to me, it's insufficient. It stops too early. What I like to add is, give a man a fish, and you feed him for a day. Teach a man to fish, and you feed him for a lifetime. Teach a man how to teach others to fish, and you feed a nation. That's the difference between duplication and facilitating duplication, teaching others how to teach these principles. When you master that, when you take it to the next level, is when your business can boom. I had a good dinner conversation last night with a good friend. He sat with me at dinner and said, Chris, I've got some challenges with my business. And I said, well, this. I said, how is your recruitment and your duplication going? He said, well, I'm not too sure. I said, well, let me ask you this one question, and I'm going to ask everyone this and answer it in your own head. I said, if you were to quit and leave this business today, how many people in your group would be able to continue with the business? And his answer was, none probably. So my answer is, you have failed in your primary objective, which is facilitating duplication. If everyone in your business needs you, you ain't no hero. You're not doing great. You're actually failing in your leadership responsibilities, because you will always be nurturing, suckling your team if they need you so much that if they can't live without you, that if you are gone for a period of time, it starts to diminish. We had Angel sit up here and talked about her horrible... Where's Angel? Where are you, baby? Angel? She's not here. Oh, there she is. She talked about her horrible year when her mother was passing away, and then like straight afterwards you had breast cancer and you couldn't get to your business. And what happened to her business during that time? It was okay. She still had residual income because she has worked on duplication. She has good leaders, and other leaders came to the rescue. That's what I wanted to hear. Give a man a fish, you feed him for a day. Teach a man to fish, you feed him for a lifetime. Teach a person to teach the principles. Teach duplication, and you'll feed a nation. You'll grow a wildly successful business. They say this is a Chinese proverb. I found the Aussie proverb equivalent. It's give a man a fish, and he'll eat for a day. Teach him how to fish, and he'll sit in a boat and drink beer all day. That's the Aussie proverb, right? Aussie equivalent. Let's keep to the Chinese proverb for the sake of this exercise. Okay, so the MLM secret of success and wealth is facilitating duplication. We saw something absolutely beautiful up on stage yesterday. We saw Sarah. Where's Sarah? There you are. I loved what you did on stage yesterday. It was beautiful because we saw the birth of a duplication. We saw someone for the first time do something technically not very well, and you're okay with me saying this, but emotionally, everything else, it was beautiful. You stood for your first presentation. You were nervous, you were crying, but you were so emotional. And at one point when you were choking people, what were we saying? What did you tell us to say? You can do it? Was it? You've got this. And we're cheering on. We saw duplication happening. Next time, Sarah's going to even be better, less nerves, and step by step, you're going to get stronger in your training, and that is duplication. Keely, she's probably behind, she's like birthed a new baby, she's given life, you've given duplication. As parents, when you have your children eventually leave home, age of 18, 19, or 25, 29 nowadays, when your child leaves home, if your child does not know how to cook, does not know how to do their own dishes and washing, in one aspect, you have failed in your duplication. Parenting is duplicating, and we hope we get it right. We hope we teach them all the life skills so that when they're on their own, they can then also continue that duplication. One mentor I like in this business very much, his name is Randy Gage. He has summarized MLM and success down to one phrase. He says, the key to everything in MLM. This is what it is. This is what we need to do. This is what it takes to have success. He says, what we do is lead a large group of people. So repeat after me. Lead a large group of people to consistently take a few simple actions. So from the top, lead a large group of people to consistently take a few simple actions over a sustained period of time. Let's all say it together. Lead a large group of people to consistently take a few simple actions over a sustained period of time. From one of the masters of our industry who's written books and books and books to summarize everything into one succinct sentence, he said, this is it. If you know this, if you can understand this, and then if you can do this, and if you can teach this, train this, then you will have success. It's inevitable. You need to lead a large group of people. So that's your initial launch in your business, your blast. Get that large group of people, your warm market, and you know the next generation. And then you teach them to consistently take a few simple actions. Keyword, simple actions, not complex actions. And I'm going to talk more about that soon. Keep it simple. And if they can consistently take a few simple actions, which is, you know, basic recruitment steps, over a sustained period of time, if you can master that formula, you've won at this business. You will have success. That is the essence of what it is, what it takes, and what we need to do. But we get it so wrong at times. We can really mess up this formula. Let me tell you what works and what doesn't work. It doesn't matter in this industry what works. What matters is what duplicates. And which one of you said the same thing yesterday. I was like, yes, that's what I'm saying tomorrow. Thank you. What matters is what duplicates. Duplication is the most important principle. So many of us tend to get caught in these sideline businesses, reshuffling, reshaping the compensation plan, finding novel ways to present products, and it's all just busy work, busy distraction. When you look at the top leaders and look at what they consistently do the same things, even down to our presentations. From everything that you saw yesterday, even though we dressed it up, tarted up with different slides, we really had the same message of recruitment and duplication. And you will never stop hearing that because it's true and it works. And we kind of exhaust ourselves trying to tell us the same things over and over again, what works. We want to hear something grand. You really want a magic key, but there is no magic key other than recruitment and duplication. What matters is what duplicates. Now, let me help you understand this because I want to help you to learn from mistakes that I have seen. This is what doesn't duplicate. Expensive meeting room hire. I liked when we saw the slide of all of our Aussie meetings. Burwood RSL. How long have we been at Burwood RSL for? 7 years? What do we pay for Burwood per week? $200. Okay, that's a good benchmark. RSL clubs. Roy and I were in Malaysia a few days ago, and one of the top leaders said, Roy, one of the things we need more help is we need a lot more money because we need to have our meetings in five-star hotels. We need to showcase Jeunesse to be at this top level. And I'm thinking, you are one of our top leaders in Malaysia. Do you not understand that that does not duplicate? You cannot, all of you cannot rent the Sheraton. Usually we don't do, this is the Royal Pine. This is once a year. This is our fancy showcase. But this is not an opportunity meeting. This does not duplicate because you can't afford it. Fancy advertising or events. I remember once in my career in Thailand, the leaders, they all got together and they branded one of the bullet trains with all of our products. And it was beautiful. And I saw that train doing the loop. It's above ground in Thailand. And it was beautiful. A beautiful waste of money because it does not duplicate. When someone joins your business and looks at that, they get the first thing, I can't do that. I can't afford that degree of advertising. I cannot have the same success you're having. So, like, to me, fail. Big fail. Customized websites. I'm exhausted by the number of people when they first join the business. Okay, the first thing I've got to do is make my own website. It's going to be a really good, powerful website. So I'm going to spend 3 months developing my own website before I launch my business. Wrong. And my leaders are laughing. I think that the two girls, they're okay with me calling them the two girls. The two girls look at each other. Yes, yes, we've experienced that. So many people want their own website. That doesn't duplicate. We give you a replicating website that works. Medical technical presentations. Doesn't work. It doesn't duplicate. Do you know that Lyndon Birnhoff is a qualified naturopath with many years of experience? How often do you stand and hear Lyndon giving medical presentations and confounding us with his knowledge about resveratrol and antioxidants and stem cells? Okay, never, except when we've asked him to help with launching of a product. You've helped us launch Vitacell, you did Vitacell. Okay, a few rare occasions has he pulled out his naturopath big guns and helped us with the big scientific medical presentation. The reason why he doesn't do it, because he knows it doesn't duplicate. If he gave medical presentations and someone joins and comes along and says, wow, this guy is so rich, he's a double diamond, I can never be a double diamond because I cannot talk this naturopath medical stuff like him. So, and you've told me that's why you choose not to do it, because that is a unique knowledge skill set you have that is generally not duplicatable. Product sampling. How many people have told me, Chris, the company needs to give us free stuff so that we can hand out that free stuff to people as sampling and get a sampling program so then they might join the company. Have you heard that one before? Have you had people ask you for samples? Okay, then my answer is, let's look at the leaders. How much free product sampling do you do in your business to help get people started? Zero. Kathy's giving me a zero. Lynn is giving me a zero. Paula's giving me a nod like, you know the answer, Chris. Zero. Product sampling doesn't work because it's not duplicatable. Our products generally are not at the price point where you can hand them away out, particularly when you first join, when your Jeunesse income is zero. So product sampling doesn't work like you hope it does. Line building offers. I've seen leaders say, now my tactic is join my business. I've got, you know, extra points or this long line. If you join, you don't have to do anything. I'll recruit people and I'll put them under you. That doesn't work. And the same with buying leads, lead programs, where people say, look, if you subscribe to my system or pay this money, I'll give you a database full of email addresses and you can mine it. Do you think if it really was that valuable, do you think they wouldn't have tapped into it themselves and exhausted that list for any qualified leads? It also, it doesn't duplicate. People who join can't spend thousands of dollars buying supposedly rich lists full of potential people willing to shell out money to join your business. Bulk buying retail programs. Again, this is real. Roy and I just last week again in Malaysia had someone come to us, a top leader in Malaysia saying, I want to see if Jeunesse is interested in this program where I buy a whole bunch of Jeunesse products and then rebrand them, we're going to relabel them and send them to this obscure country where they can sell them through some retail channels. Would Jeunesse be interested in that? And I say, hell no, we're not interested in that because that does not duplicate. This is a one-off, it's going to be a whole lot of work, very difficult, highly risky, and is anyone in your team ever going to have success with this? But quite often I hear these bulk buying programs, so proposals. Okay, let me tell you though what does duplicate. This is what does duplicate, and sorry if I'm boring you, sorry if you've heard it before, but it is the simple truth. What does duplicate? Company third-party tools. We give you a whole bunch of tools, brochures, the replicating website. I'll show you our main website now that's a repository for all of our material. Home meetings. You've all got a home. You can all invite 2, 3, 5, maybe up to 20 people in your home for a home meeting. That duplicates. Three-way calls. They've always worked. They're still working. It's one of the main tools you can use, especially when you're brand new, to help grow and help recruit and help duplicate. Replicating websites. Like I said, don't start your own website. Don't build your, spend $1,000. We have great website materials, you know, JTools. There's a whole bunch of stuff that Jeunesse has more than any of us realize, more than any of us use. There's a whole new J Mobile that's launched a few months ago, and I've barely even tapped into it to study its power. Replicating websites work. Webinars work, and we've been doing them since day one in Australia. Testimonials. Nothing impacts more than the testimonials of, like Sarah's testimonial on stage. I remember that because I remember the feeling. I may not remember her words, I remember the slide, but I remember how I felt and her sincerity in sharing that testimonial. Testimonials will always be one of our strongest tools for recruitment in this business, and that is one of the most easiest things to duplicate. Find your testimonial, share your testimonial. Jeunesse events, social media sharing. This is what works, and this is what we've all stood trying to impress upon you. Okay, tools, access marketing tools at sharejeunesse.com. This, I'm guilty of not understanding the potential of this. I had to launch Reveal a couple of weeks ago in another market, and I'm writing to America saying, look, I need this material. I need a PowerPoint of Reveal. I need all of the images. I need to see a video of Christian Drapeau on stage presenting it so I can understand. And they said, go here. And I said, no, I'm corporate. I'm not, do you understand I need all of this stuff? And they said, Chris, do you understand if you go here, everything that you have said is on this website. And sure enough, the PowerPoint that I needed was there, a video of Christian, Revita Blue, and for the Reveal. All those videos for the last like 5 events in the USA, all the videos are there. If you want banners, if you want brochures, all of that is available on sharejeunesse.com. So go there, play around with it, see the tools that are available. So, stick to the formula. If there is a summary of what I'm talking about and what our leaders have talked about today, like I said, it's back to basics today. There is a formula, and it's a formula that it works. We are honored to be amongst not great leaders just in Jeunesse, but some of the greatest MLM networkers in the world. Do you know, Paula, I wish we'd given you a better introduction. I want you to know this lady, is it correct? You were the very first female diamond in Amway? Is that the first? Sorry? It's in North America. Amway, huge. International Day of Women. You heard yesterday her ferocious tenacity when she decided, I'm going to do this, how, you know, the energy that she went into this business. She became one of the top leaders in Amway and the top female leader on her own, smashing this business. And she told you how she did it. And you've done it again. I know your last company, and so at least three MLMs, is there more than that? That you have risen to the top again and again. Lyndon as well, I've known Lyndon for maybe 15 years. He was the top leader. And is it luck? Is it luck that you can become the top again and again? It's not. It's knowing the formula and applying the formula again and again that helps you rise to the top of business. Stick to the formula. What is the formula? Let's talk about systems and duplication. How to create massive duplication. You understand this formula. You understand McDonald's system of duplication. It's really simple, not quite, but simple enough that they take it, they boil it down to a book, and they put a 15-year-old in front of a counter. They teach them these principles so that 15-year-old can then go anywhere else and start up a McDonald's, become a general manager, because they give them such a tight system of which order the lettuce, cheese, tomatoes goes, how many items you place in a bag, what's, you know, the secret recipe sources, all the rest. The McDonald's system of duplication, they apply a system, and you can call it this, systems save yourself stress, time, effort, and money. Why reinvent the system? Why reinvent the wheel? It takes more time, and you're not likely to improve it. You're not likely to do better than the proven system. You may walk into McDonald's and think, oh, if I was in charge of McDonald's, I could do so much better. I would do all these things differently. You know, probably not. Probably not, because what they do is really, really good, really, really refined, down to one of the best art forms in the world. When it comes to duplication, this is one of the key mathematical formulas. It's an easy formula. When you increase the complexity of things, you decrease duplication. When you make things more difficult, more tricky, more complex, when you add more systems and programs, when you try and change the basic Jeunesse structure of how we work, how we do the compensation plan, how we recruit, you're less likely to have duplication. You understand it's like McDonald's. It's quite simple. It's easy to duplicate. I want to finish with this again, because if you could memorize anything or get a takeaway, it is this. Do you know Randy Gage? Have you heard of him before? Yep. He's written like many, many books, and he's risen to the top of maybe three or four MLMs, multi-million dollar income earner, probably one of the highest paid speakers in our industry. He speaks this much, but someone said, give me one sentence. So he studied it carefully, and this is what he came up with. The key to success in this industry is to lead a large group of people to consistently take a few simple actions again and again, repeating them, recycling them over a sustained period of time. If you get this, if you understand this, if you can teach this, if you can infuse this through your team, something as simple as this, you will have success. And that is my hope for you, my prayer for you. It's what I do passionately, trying to teach people and help people to understand this principle of enrollment and duplication. In Australia, New Zealand, we need a lot more duplication. First of all, we need a lot more enrollment. Agreed? So I hope that can be our focus for the next while. We've gotten on some tangents. We've done different things. Please, we need to get back to the enrollment. Feel your pulse of your business. If you're palpitating, if you're flatlining, I say it's because your enrollment is not in check. Check your enrollment. How's your enrollment doing? All the time, focus on your duplication. How am I doing? Are you a Chris Cooper who vacuums the grass and wears one of those shirts saying, you know, I can do everything, leave it to me? You need to duplicate. You need to trust your team. You need to put your fledgling leaders on stage. And even if they're on stage, even if they're crying, it's great because they're there, they're doing it, they're growing, they're stepping out of their comfort zone, and they're going to get better and better and better. And that's duplication. That's what we need to succeed. Enrollment, duplicate. Thank you, everyone.